Good afternoon. Welcome to Metropolitan United Church. My name is Patricia Wright. I'm the Minister of Music here at Metropolitan, and I'm delighted to see you here in person up in the balcony and also online for our very first Noon at Met concert in approximately 4 years. We were shut down for 2 years when we were undergoing some major renovations, and then, of course, during the COVID pandemic. This is only the second in-person and live stream concert that we have had, and the last being last Friday night's Phantoms of the Organ. Metropolitan United Church is a shining light in downtown Toronto and has been for over 200 years. Now, we don't have, because of COVID, we've removed all of our brochures, but go to our website, metunited.ca, and those of you online, I'm sure you found us on the website too, for information about the church. This particular building has been on this site since 1872. The original building burned in 1928, was rebuilt in 1929. The organ you are about to hear, it was built by the Casavant Company from outside Montreal, so it's a Canadian instrument. It was installed in 1930. The main part of the organ, which is over 7,900 pipes, the main pipes are up here behind the carvings on either side of the chancel. And then in 1998, we added a gallery division, and that's hanging on the back wall of the church. And even before we added the gallery division, this was deemed to be the largest pipe organ in Canada. So if you are here for the first time, you're about to hear the largest pipe organ in Canada. Now, those of you who have been familiar with our Noon at Met concerts, we used to be on Thursdays. We've moved to Fridays, and we have four concerts planned here in November and December. The next one, as you see in the bottom of your program, those of you here, will be on November 19th. We're also just beginning to add a few more events in. Again, you can find them on our website, but a big one is next Friday night. And Music Theatre International out of New York City has made available to music theatre groups all over the world, free of licensing fees, a set of 15 songs and photographs or illuminations, whatever, and the tracks that can be used and in concert. And it's a way to get music theater back in groups. On next Friday, and it will not stay on our website, but live here and online, we will be doing the only production all together now, the only production in the GTA. So the information is at the bottom of your printed programs, and I think on the live stream we will show some advertising. We're raising money in this event for our very, very active community services program, which provides needed services in all areas to the vulnerable in downtown Toronto. So Metropolitan, a church that serves the downtown, that has wonderful worship and music. Today, you will hear a concert by Joshua Duncan Lee, and you can read Josh's biography on your printed program. Josh is our new organ scholar here. We have a series of organ scholars we've trained over the years. Josh is only 17 years old, but he has a list of credits to his name that put many of us to shame. So the program consists of one of the chorales by César Franck. Franck was a 19th century organist in Paris, primarily at the Church of St. Clotilde in Paris. And then a Tiento by the 17th century Spanish composer Correa de Arauxo. Herbert Howells, Siciliano. Howells was a 20th century English composer. And then the last movement from a symphony of Louis Vierne. Louis Vierne was a late 19th century, early 20th century French composer, and he was the organist at Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. So with that, would you please join me in welcoming Joshua Duncan Lee?